Hi everyone. So I just had to come back on today and share another pretty awesome rapture dream I had yesterday when I laid down to take a nap. Yesterday I was just spending the day cleaning my garage and I had my worship music cranked. I was just in the spirit, just praising the Lord. And before I knew it was 4 o'clock and I was just absolutely tired. So I decided to go lay down and take a nap for a couple hours. But you guys, with that said, with all the dreams that I've been getting, I just want you guys to know that I am nobody special. All the people on YouTube that get dreams and visions, we are no more special in the Lord's eyes than the next person. We're all equal. But I believe the Lord gives us these dreams because He knows that we're going to share them. We're just vessels for the Lord. We're just messengers. And like me personally, I get so excited when I get my rapture dreams, and I'm just cannot wait to get on here and share them with you guys. So I believe that's why the Lord uses us, is just for the simple fact is we get those messages out there. So again, guys, we're nobody special. We're just doing the Lord's work. And for me personally, I asked the Lord a couple years ago. I said, I just want to do more for the kingdom of God, and I don't know what else I can do because I'm so busy running my assisted living. And soon after that's when I started getting my dreams and stuff. So I just wanted to share that with you guys. And if you're still wanting the rapture dreams and visions and words from the Lord, I just encourage you guys to keep praying about it and keep asking the Lord to give you one. And I believe He will, you guys. If you truly want Him with all your heart, I believe He'll answer your prayers and He'll give you something. And one way or another, He will give you something. So I just encourage you guys just to keep on pressing upon the Lord. And just praying about it, and I believe He'll answer your prayers. But you guys, I want to make this video short because the last couple videos I've did have been just kind of long. So yesterday, I laid down about 4 o'clock and I fell asleep instantly. And I had a dream that I was at this event back in Minnesota. And you guys, I'm live in Montana. I've been here for 15 years, but this is where I was born and raised, was in Minnesota till I was 29, and then I moved to Montana. So I was back home visiting my grandpa, and we were at this event. And in my dream, I did not want to be at this event. I just did not want to be there. I was so upset in my dream for being there. And I believe it was just a representation of the world. So in the beginning of the dream, I was just watching people. Just people watching, basically, just watching people come in and out of the building and dancing, and it was just full of people. And one of my girlfriends from high school came up to me, and I just said, I want to go home. And she says, well, I think Jared will be here any moment. I'm sure he'll give you a ride home. So her name was Christy, and you guys, I looked these names up, and Jared, which I shared this dream with Amanda. She believes this represented Jesus. Jared represented Jesus. I was blown away when I looked up his name. It means he's descending, and it also means roses, flowers. And if you guys have been with me for a while, you know how much I love my flower beds. And I love, love, love roses. And I had a flower bed done. Just in memory of my grandma, because that was her favorite flower too, was roses. So I have tons of flower beds in my yard, but one specifically is just in memory of my grandma. So I was just like, wow, that his name meant roses as well. But it was a double, double wow about he's descending. So then this morning, I looked up the meaning of Christy. Christy means anointed, follower of Christ. So I walked into this other part of this event, and there was long, long tables there just with a bunch of stuff you could buy. And at the end of this table were these candy bars, and they were called World's Finest Chocolates. If you guys have ever, I'm sure some of you guys know about these candy bars, but they are for fundraising. And back in sixth grade, we had to sell these candy bars to pay for our trip to Minneapolis. And the biggest thing about this trip was to go see the Minnesota Twins. And so I was pretty excited when I saw these candy bars because they're like the best candy ever. And I haven't had one for, oh my gosh, decades. So I went up to the cash register to pay for these candy bars. I grabbed every single one of them, and they were $40. So when I shared this dream with Amanda, I said, "I know that you had received 40. I'm not sure what this represents." But she said, "A lot of people had dreams about $40. It was two $20 bills." So she didn't really elaborate on what she thought the $40 was, and I'm not sure, you guys, but that was the amount of the candy bars. So the next thing is that we're in the car, and I was still extremely upset because I didn't have a vehicle and I just wanted to go home. And my aunt and my uncle were talking in the front seat. My grandpa and I were in the back seat, and they started mocking my dad. And I believe my dad represented Jesus as well, but in real life, my dad didn't really talk about Jesus. He didn't preach the gospel. But I knew that's what they were mocking in my dream. They were saying scripture and then laughing. And I just knew in my dream they were mocking my dad for the way he preached the gospel. So I got upset and I said, "You guys better knock it off. Quit mocking the Lord, and you're gonna basically be sorry." So I was extremely upset with them. The next thing I know is we're going up this huge hill, and at the top of the hill, right to the left, there was a train station. And I was walking up to the train station. I just stood there and I started looking at everything because it was so beautiful, and there was these white lights that were like on the rain gutters or whatever. They were surrounding the train station, and I immediately remembered the dream. And I just shared this that not that long ago. I had this dream probably about a year ago. I'm not going to tell the dream, but it was where missiles were coming down and there was war happening. And then I ran to a friend's house, and as soon as I got to her house, it just felt like it was peace. And she had just had a baby. And when I walked into her house had these white lights on it. So that's the first thing that came to my mind was that dream. In that dream, she had, I asked her what the baby's name was, and she said Jules. So I went up to her crib thing, and she was wearing a purple t-shirt, and it said Happy Easter on it. So I'm standing here looking at this depot, this train station, and I hear my grandma say Chanda. And I turned around, and she had a big smile on her face, and she walked up and grabbed my arm, and she said, "It's time to go home." And we got into the train, the doors closed, and the train started moving, and then my alarm went off. Of course, because that always happens to me. And I was telling my husband last night, I said, "I swear the Lord sits there and looks at the clock, you know, like 4 minutes and 30 seconds before my alarm goes off or my bladder is full where I have to go and go to the bathroom. I always get to like the best part of the dream where I want the dream to continue, but it doesn't." So it's like he's watching the clock going, "Okay, her alarm's gonna go off in 4 minutes. Start the dream now," and then starts my dream because it always ends like at the best part. But in this dream, you guys, the train started, it started moving, and then that was the end of my dream. So, you guys, that was a pretty awesome dream. I just wanted to come on and share it. Also, I wanted to share with you guys is I watched Sid Roth Supernatural last night, and it was a pretty awesome program. He had a gentleman on there. I believe his name was Kevin. I encourage you guys to watch the whole thing. I'm going to leave the link in the description box below. He was just talking about the power of prayer, the power of tongues. It was just, again, I can't stress it enough. It was just an awesome program. But at the end, the last 10 minutes of the program, he had told us that Jesus came to him one night and he was standing at the end of the bed and he was playing the saxophone. And he said, "Come here, I want to teach you this." And he says, "I can't play the saxophone." He goes, "Yes, you can." And so Jesus played the saxophone. He played this song. And so the gentleman, Kevin, learned the song. And when he does his little events or whatever, like Sid Roth, he plays this song for the audiences, basically for healing and blessings and stuff like that. And I just thought it was so awesome. I was so excited for him to start playing the saxophone. So they went to a quick commercial, came back, and he started playing the song, you guys. It was absolutely beautiful. But what was just like a wow factor about this was the name of the song came up, and the name was Spring. So he started playing the song, and people just started, you know, lifting their hands up and crying. It was so beyond touching. I cried a little bit, and it was so beautiful. So again, guys, I'm going to leave the link in the description box below. That part, again, I encourage you guys to watch the whole thing, but if you just want to see the part with the saxophone, started at 19 minutes, 30 seconds, and that'll bring you to that part. But you guys, again, we're just so close. We are so, so close. Just be ready every day. Like I said, I love you. Jesus loves you. Have a great week. God bless.